Hello there. I'm Green Deane. As you can see, it's getting a little warm here in Florida, but thanks, and get a little insects too, got a few mosquitoes. But thanks for joining me on my 30th video here at EatTheWeeds.com. Today we're going to be talking about the yellow nuphar, the yellow pond lilies. It's going to be the nuphar lutea. It's going to be somewhere near you because it grows almost everywhere on Earth except the Arctic and the Antarctic, and you can find it in temperate and tropical climates. So there's a nuphar near you. Now, how do we take advantage of that? Well, the question is, how edible is the nuphar? So let's go take a look at them, maybe some photos, and then we'll go run out in the field, then we'll come back and we'll itemize. Well, here we have the classic nuphar leaf and blossom. Notice how it's heart-shaped, and it also repels water. And here we're going to take a closer look at the three-petal nuphar blossom, plus a seed casing in the making with the very telltale red tip. Of course, later on it loses that. What you're going to see here is a typical arrangement of yellow pond lilies. They like to cover an area just about as completely as they can, and there's a good representation here. You know, there's one other thing I should mention about these. Now, I'm talking about some edible young leaves, like here's one. We just get my foot wet here. Like here's a young one that's on that verge of being edible. See this bronze one's coming out of the water. Okay. Now normally these young leaves are underwater, and that's when you want to get them, these young leaves. And the Indians would know their pond so well that to them it was like a water garden. They would know what time of year to pick things out, and they would actually get these leaves before they started to float and turn color. And that's when you want to get them. You actually want to get these leaves when they're underwater. It's the best time to get these young ones for eating. So when you start to see them on top, these bronze ones, that's a little, it's not too late, but you really should get them at a much younger age. Here we have the nuphar blossom, so we get nice and close here. The some of the petals are also sepals, but they use the completely yellow petals for teas. It has a lovely smell to it. And if we get deep inside, you can see the part that turns into this. There we go. So. You know, they say it smells like brandy, but I don't think so. These have got very, very young seeds in them. Let's see if we can just give this a cut here. If you take a look, very hard to see, I see with this light. It looks almost like corn in there. We're almost too young to see in this one. Let's see if I have another one here if I can pick on. Cut the end off. And we're getting some bigger seeds. There we go. And these look even more like corn. As the season goes on, they get definitely encapsulated. Now these even more resemble kernels of corn, and still quite edible. You can eat them raw, but they're much tastier cooked. Take off another one here, and see if we can just get around the outside of this just a little. Now these are older. See, they're turning color on us. Let's cut this one open. They're no longer yellow. They're taking on a dark hue. They're turning brown. And this is the color when you're going to start to pop them. They don't really pop like popcorn. They don't really pop like popcorn. They kind of pop like peas. Crack like peas. But you can also hear them. So those would be good for popping. They're easy to collect. You simply go across the top of the pond and just pull them off. Easy to take them out. And they're a little on the mucilage side, but quite easy. So the calories in, calories out. You're going to get more calories out than you are putting calories in to get these. Unlike the roots, which are a huge calorie expenditure to get, and they just don't cook up well. I actually soaked these for a little while in water. I think soaking in water reduces the bitterness a little. Now, some authors actually say these are always bitter. I've never found that the case. To me, they've always been pretty palatable when they're cooked. And of course, you can grind these up and make a paste out of them too, flour to make a bread. But I just kind of like them this way. Starting to pop on me here. Now, rightfully, you should do this with a cover on. I'm doing them now so you can just see them popping. So I'm trying to keep them from flying off the pan with my spatula. Here we have some pop seeds. Nufar. A little salt. And we have ourselves a snack. Of course, if you had more of these, you'd have a meal. If you had even more, you'd have bread. Here in Eat the Weeds, we itemize. So let's itemize the nufar. Identification. It's a large floating leaf with a split. That's important because other lilies don't have the split, so that helps you identify it. It has round petaled flowers, not sharp petals, but round petals, and they're very, very fragrant, and they're yellow, always yellow. And the seed casing is tulip-shaped with a little flat dish on the end. And it's full of seeds that are about the size of small peas, maybe up to size peas, depending on where they're growing. Time of year. Young leaves year-round, except in the wintertime. Seed pods are seasonal, which here in Florida is almost most of the year, but farther north will be in towards the fall. And flowers whenever they're in blossom, which is usually most of the season also. Environment. Now, that's pretty easy. They like ponds. Like the edge of the shallow lakes and the edge of the slow rivers. And by the way, they're a pretty good indicator of water quality. Nufars do not like to grow in bad water or polluted water. Of course, what is the measure of pollution? But the water usually has to be fairly good for them to grow in, fairly clear. That doesn't mean you can eat them without cooking. You still should cook them, but they tend to grow in better water instead of bad water. Method of preparation. Young leaves can be eaten raw or cooked. I think they're far better cooked. Because they tend to be on the bitter side. You can dry the seeds and pop them like popcorn, although they don't really pop, they kind of crack. And or you can grind the seeds into a flour and make a dampers or a cake out of them. And the petals can be made into a tea. As for the roots, I can't recommend them. And to be frank, I don't know any more modern forager who does. There are some literatures, reports from 300 to 400 years ago that says Native Americans ate them. It's a famine food. But you know, there's no reports of them elsewhere in the world being done that way. And all my efforts to make them edible have never worked out, as you can read about at my blog on them. So I cannot recommend the roots as a source of food. I want to thank you for joining me on my 30th video here on EatTheWeeds.com on this mosquito warm morning. You can tell what season we're having here, can't you? Now, if you want to know more about the nufar or the yellow pond lily or other edible plants in this area, you know, go to EatTheWeeds.com and you'll find about 100 other plants there. So until next time, this is Green Deane. I want you to think green. I want you to eat green. And that includes the green pond lily with the yellow flower, the nufar lutea. So until next time.